FM dipole for radio station transmitters, a homemade build using parts you can find at your local hardware store. That's what we're building today. I know a lot of people are excited to build this FM dipole antenna from all the messages I've been getting, so let's jump into it. To build this antenna, you will need these parts. Here are the measurements for the parts in metric as well as imperial measurements. Here are the tools that you will need to complete this build as well. Let's start with how the whole antenna fits together. You have two radials. They are both a quarter of a wavelength long and together make up a half wavelength. The top and bottom radials are made of two parts. They are both rods made of aluminium, or aluminum as they say in the USA. You need to have a thinner inner tube which slides inside the end of the bigger tube. The reason for this is that the antenna needs to be adjustable in length to be tunable. Now, to assemble the antenna, you need to firstly cut the rods to the right length, then mark the outer side of the thicker rod with some tape. The reason is that the outer part needs to have a small cut made and the inner part needs to have small holes drilled into it. You will see why in a second. So avoid confusion and accidentally cutting the wrong side. Make sure you mark the outer edge with red tape and do this for both of the 18mm thicker tubes. The inner tube doesn't need to be marked. The inner aluminium tubes are 13mm thick. The idea is to have aluminium or aluminum rods that can slip easily inside each other without wobbling around, so a snug fit is best. That way you will be able to adjust the length of the antenna and be able to lock it in place with the hose clamp, also known as a worm drive clamp, so that it does not accidentally change length. So on the end you've marked with some red tape, let's call it the outer edge, cut a groove a bit deeper than the hose clamp is wide, so if the hose clamp is 10mm or 0.4 inches, then the cut will be 15mm or 0.6 inches deep. Do this for both wider aluminium tubes, but only on the marked end. Now take your plastic box. This can be a junction box like this one, or almost any plastic box as long as it is big enough and can be sealed to not have water get in it. It needs to be at least 100mm by 100mm in size and 50mm deep. A plastic junction box is easy to work with because you just need to saw off the size of the hole you need with a hacksaw. A normal plastic box will need a very big drill bit of about 18mm, or you can use a hole saw attached to a drill. Also cut a hole on this side for the coaxial cable to go in. Make the hole wide enough for the coaxial cable, but not too wide because you will need to seal this hole too. Then take the two wider tubes and place a short piece of wooden dowel stick between them and cover it with some glue. It can be super glue or almost any other glue like contact glue or epoxy glue, but not silicone glue. Slide the aluminium tubes over the wooden dowel stick before it dries. Make sure you leave a gap of 5mm between the two tubes. Make sure that they don't touch. Let the glue dry. Once the glue is dry and solid, using a drill with a 7mm drill bit, drill four holes close to the center join. The spacing of the holes is 40mm apart for the inner holes, and the outer holes are 80mm apart. Then slide the two joined tubes into the plastic box through the holes you cut. Make sure the join is exactly in the center and hold it still while you drill through the holes in the join tubes through to the back of the plastic box. Then take the tube or pole out and push the 50mm bolts through the back of the box. You want to eventually end up with this setup where the bolts hold the pole with the nuts like this. You might need to find very narrow nuts to make this fit depending on the size of your plastic box. The problem is that you can't slide the pole into the box with the bolts and nuts like this. So you have to remove the pole and place the nuts on the ends of the bolts like this, then drop the bolts down as low as they can go to allow the pole to be able to fit back into the plastic box. Once the pole is back in, turn the bolt threads from outside the box to let the bolts pass through the pole and the nuts. Then when the bolts are all the way up, adjust the one nut to the bottom and the other to the top like this on all the bolts. Now place a nut on the top of only the outer bolts to hold it in place. The inner bolts still need to have the eyelets from the coaxial cable connected before you can put those nuts on. You then slide the thinner rod into the thicker rod. Now, using the hose clamps, aka worm drive clamps, slide the hose clamps over the ends of each pole and move it to over the join and tighten it up. Don't over tighten it because it can strip the thread and you will need to get a new one. Just tighten it till the thin rod no longer can slide in or out. Now we need to attach the support arm that will connect your antenna to the pole or mast. It's a square aluminium pole and not a round aluminium tube like the antenna's radials. The support arm needs to line up just next to the pole edge, but on the outside. If you could see through into the box, it would look like this. To line it up accurately, you can use some thin cotton or thread that you tie between the two poles and run it over the back of the box. Then adjust the square aluminium pole till it just touches the string. Now, drill two holes evenly spaced apart through the square aluminium and drill through the plastic box as well. Insert the bolts from the inside of the box, reaching out the back of the box, then place the nuts on the outside, unlike the antenna pole that has the nuts on the inside of the box. Now, push the coaxial cable into the box and attach the eyelets using a soldering iron. Place the eyelets onto the two bolts nearest the center, then put the nuts over the eyelets. You can push the cables together to neaten it up. Make sure the eyelet of the center core of the coaxial cable goes to the top radial and the braiding eyelet goes to the bottom radial. These cables need to be very short and only long enough to reach the bolts in the two rods. Then attach a connector on the end of the coaxial cable. This cable can be as long as you want, but normally about a quarter of a wavelength is good. You can then attach a barrel connector to it and join your long antenna cable there. Be sure to make the connectors the same type, like PL259 or N-type, etc., or you will need to use adapters which can drop your signal a bit. Now we need to make the bracket for the support arm. This can be very tricky, so be sure to follow this process carefully. You will end up with holes like this where the U-bolts will go through. There are two U-bolts on one side and two on the back. One is for the vertical pole and the other is for the support arm square aluminium tube. First, put paper tape over the metal plate and mark the center point with two lines. Also write which is the top end to not confuse the horizontal with the vertical. First, put the U-bolt over the plate to mark the holes for the vertical pole. Space these evenly, giving space on the edges. Try to keep them as centered as possible. Then mark the U-bolts for the horizontal support arm. These need to be outside the space of the vertical pole. This is very important. The U-bolts for the horizontal pole can be smaller because the square pole of the support arm is often thinner than your antenna mast or pole. The holes will be closer together for a smaller clamp, but must still be outside of the vertical antenna path. Then drill the holes with a drill bit to match the thickness of your U-bolts. Remove the tape to see the clean holes. Put the bracket on the end of the square aluminium tubing. The vertical U-bolts go in front and the U-bolts for the horizontal support arm go on the back. Make sure the bracket is the right way around and the correct U-bolts are inserted. Then tighten all the screws so that the antenna is solid and the connectors are not moving around but are nice and solid. Then use a glue gun or some silicone glue and seal up the hole where the cable goes in. Put some cable ties over the coaxial cable and support arm to keep the coaxial cable from flopping around. Then seal the holes where the antenna poles come out. Make sure there are no holes for water to get in. Place plastic caps over the ends of the antenna radials. Screw the lid back onto the plastic box. If you want to completely insulate the antenna from water like rain, you can glue over the bolts on the back of the box. It will not make a huge difference as the water between the two will mostly just run off and not do very much, but if you want it perfectly insulated, glue it up, but don't use silicone glue here, because some silicone glue is a semiconductor. In dry conditions, it will make no difference at all. You now have a complete FM dipole antenna. To tune your new antenna correctly, watch this video. And to understand more about FM radio station antennas, check out this video.